Hello, Andrew Wasson from CreativeGuitarStudio.com. If there's one thing that musicians hate, it's playing wrong notes. Unfortunately, this issue is almost impossible to stop altogether since we are human, we're not computers, we're not robots. But, you know, there are ways of going about significantly reducing wrong notes when you're playing songs or you're soloing. And I have a short list I put together for you of how to do that. Four things I want to run through with you. And if you stick through to the end, the fourth item that I have in the list is going to be accompanied by a pretty interesting story. And I think you're really going to find this quite something. It's something that I was surprised about, and it's something I learned on teaching now for 26 years. It's quite interesting. So stick with me through these four points. Like I said, the fourth one is going to be quite interesting for you. All right, the most important one right out of the gate, number one, practice the new material that you're getting into perfectly. Don't do it sloppy, don't do it rushed, don't go at a pace where it's too fast too soon, because you're just going to program in mistakes. And it happens so quickly, you play a wrong note or two, and then they stay with you. It's like they get programmed into your brain much faster than the correct notes, and then you have to go through an unlearning process and you have to relearn. So make sure that when you practice new material, you're doing it perfectly. You know, there was an old music teacher I had who used to say, perfect practice makes for perfect playing. And that is such a true statement. If you take that slower approach to the music that you're working on, you're going to find that your memory will be able to recall it in a much cleaner way from your mind that just creates much higher levels of perfection overall. So take that to heart, practice new material perfectly, and take that saying very seriously as well. Memorize it and say it to yourself over and over again through your career as a musician. Perfect practice makes for perfect playing. Okay, the next item on the list for being able to begin really eliminating a lot of those wrong notes in your guitar playing is to record ideas. Record ideas that you're working on for your band or your jam nights that you do with your friends. Record yourself practicing simple exercises, whether that's a scale or an arpeggio, simple chord progression, working on rhythm guitar, whatever it is. You should be spending time recording yourself playing guitar almost every single day. And if you aren't, start doing this as soon as possible. When you hit that record button, you know, what happens is most musicians slightly tense up because you're generally kind of concerned you're going to make mistakes. So, you know, you get a bit tense, you know, that affects your playing. Tension is pretty much a musician's worst enemy. So, you know, the more that you record yourself, the more you're going to get used to that feeling of tension. You'll be able to control it, and overall, you'll become a lot more confident. And you'll find the confidence will spread. You know, you'll be better jamming with your friends. You'll be better up on stage when you get those gigs that you got to play. And then the next time you get into a really serious recording environment, you know, in a studio or something, you're going to feel much more confident about yourself. All right, the next important point I want to bring up here is to sing. Sing what you play. Guitar players, especially rhythm and lead players, are one of the worst groups of music students out there when it comes to not going and spending time singing on phrases that they're practicing. And, you know, this is so important to do because when you sing a musical idea or when you vocalize the rhythmic meter of a groove or something like that, what you're really doing is you're internalizing the music and you're feeling it at a much higher level to your body, and it just simply doesn't get any better than that. So remember that one of the best things that you can do when it comes down to reaching for playing perfection, you know, so that you, you know, learn how to get as good as possible at avoiding wrong notes, is to start singing more. You know, do that. Sing scales, sing arpeggios, sing through the tones of chords. I have a full, you know, ear training program on my site that I'm working through right now with students, and you know, you can work on that course too through my website, you know, but the idea is doing singing is going to help you better internalize musical passages, and you will play them better and you'll play them more accurately. It also helps your body to physically relate to the music in a way really that no other practice method really can do. Well, I did say if you stuck around to the last point, I had something very interesting to talk with you about. And this last point is on saying the names of notes out loud. Now, this is different than singing. This is really mostly related to scale and arpeggio practice, but you could possibly do with chords if you call out the chord tones. It works very well also with licks and melodies and riffs. But the idea is that as you go through a lick or a run, you're going to say the note names out loud. Not singing them, but just saying them out loud as you're playing them. And what's going to happen is a very strange thing, actually. It's going to be completely unconscious. Your mind is going to lock into those notes through their name in a much deeper way so that you avoid mistakes. Now, I know this is a hard thing to relate to if you're maybe a newer musician, kind of beginner, introductory, intermediate level, maybe even reaching those, you know, starting points of the advanced level of playing. But I'll tell you, after teaching for 26 years and sitting in front of over 1,000 people for all those days and all that, I have noticed something very odd. And this was the story I wanted to tell you. If I sit in front of a student and I'm talking about a run and I'll tell them, put your finger on the third string, on the seventh fret or on the ninth fret or something like that, they struggle with a little bit, especially beginner, you know, some of the intermediate level students, they're thinking, oh, okay, third string, ninth fret, you know, whatever. And if I say at that time in that mix, if I say it's an E note, something very odd happens. Their finger just like a magnet just zips right over to exactly where it has to go. Now, I have no idea why this is the case. If you're a guitar teacher, try this with your students. It's a very odd phenomenon. I have no idea why it's so. But I have found that if I start off and tell a student, you know, go to the third string or go to the fourth string, play the third fret, you know, and then all of a sudden I say, it's an F, bam, the finger just goes to it like lightning. I don't know what's up with this, but there's some connection we've got on an unconscious level. And I'm talking, you know, I got to clarify, I'm talking about students who don't know any notes on the neck. I mean, these are usually pretty rookie level guitar students, you know, so if they're introductory beginners or if they're, you know, even in the intermediate level, a lot of times you don't know your notes all over the guitar fingerboard. But I've found over the years of teaching that for some bizarre reason, this works for, I don't even know why, I have no clue why it actually operates the way it does. Like I said, if you're a guitar teacher, try this, you'll find some pretty surprising things happen with it. But, you know, saying notes, say notes out loud, whether you're going through a run of a scale or you're practicing arpeggios, get it going, because I don't know what it does exactly, but it does do something pretty miraculous. Well, if you'd like to learn more about what I do as an online guitar teacher, visit my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and start looking through all my guitar courses. There are dozens and dozens of lesson plans, all with very detailed videos and PDF worksheets that you can download, print out, put up in your music stand, and start working through to learn much more about the guitar. The lessons are all very well planned, they're easy to follow, and they work in a very organized way so that in the end, whether you're a beginner and you're moving through that program of mine, maybe you're working through intermediate level, or perhaps you're even an advanced player and you're working through some of my advanced program material, it's going to help you increase your knowledge on guitar, do it in a very organized chapter by chapter, step by step way, and it'll start helping you to incorporate much higher end guitar skills for the music that you enjoy playing. And as always, I'd like to end off by saying thanks for joining me. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more, and remember to hit that bell when you subscribe so you never miss another one of my uploads to YouTube. Until next time, take care, and we'll catch up again on the next video. Bye for now. When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.